to be your guide.
Let's get out of here quick!
Here we go, guys. Move on.
Retreat!
Wait.
I'll go
easy on you.
Hey, can't be helped. Wait.
Thank you.
Looks like we got a tough fight ahead of us. What goes around comes around.
Amina! Amina!
This who you're talking about?
Yeah. Well, she okay?
She's still breathing, but I don't think her chances are good.
Let's get her back to town, quick!
Oh. See you guys later, then. Glad we found the girl.
Thanks, we really appreciate your help.
Don't sweat it. One good turn deserves another. See ya!
Let's hurry.
Yeah.
So happy she's home safe, thanks to all of you.
It was nothing.
No, the doctor said that had you found her much later, it might have been too late. Oh, I feel so sorry for the poor girl. She lost both of her parents and now this disease.
Ma'am?
Oh, it's all the war's fault. If it wasn't for this war, Amina's parents wouldn't have died and she could have lived in peace.
That's why the killing has to end.
Indeed. But there's not much we can do. All we can do is make wishing charms and pray that Abris ends the war. If only I had the power, I'd smash those Aeroglyph scum into little pieces! Powerless.
Power. Amina.
Fate? Why are you here?
Don't get up, Amina. You have to rest.
Why are you here, Fate? I thought you were going to leave for Aquios today.
Well,
these people brought you back here after you collapsed. You collapsed on top of the mountain, Amina. I couldn't carry you all the way home, so I came back to get help. But that's when I saw this boy.
I see. Fate, everyone, thank you very much. I'm so sorry for the trouble I've caused you all.
Nah, don't worry about it.
He's right. You just concentrate on resting up and getting better.
Okay.
And Amina?
Yes?
I asked that doctor to take care of you for me. If you start feeling worse, go see her right away.
But how will I pay her?
That's not a problem. We've already come to an agreement about the fee. It's all taken care of.
I can't let you do that.
You need to learn to take favors when they're offered. Don't worry. You don't owe me anything. That doctor is an old friend of mine. I'm happy to use my connections to help.
She's right. Listen, she says it's okay, so it's okay.
But...
how about this? Just think of it as payment for the Maiden of Orisa. Does that sound fair?
That was a gift.
Come on, just say yes.
You want to see your friend again, don't you? You'll need to get better as fast as possible if you want to do that, right?
I don't know how to thank you.
Don't mention it. Fate?
Yeah. Amina? Sorry, but we have to go.
You do?
I'd like to stay and help you get better, but there's something important I have to do. It's something I've thought about a lot. At first, I was just going to run away from it all. But then I realized, sometimes you're the only one that can make a difference. And if it's something that might help people, you've got to give it a try.
Yes.
Fate, you don't mean...
That's right. I'll cooperate with you. Of my own free will, of course. So let's go, before I change my mind again.
Okay.
You're as easy to read as always.
I'll take that as a compliment. All right, we have to go now. I'm sorry, ma'am. Please take good care of Amina.
I will. You folks take care of your own work, whatever that may be. Leave Amina to me.
Thank you.
Fate?
Huh?
I'll see you again, right?
Yes, you will.
I'm looking forward to it.
I am too. Take care.
All right.
You sure about this?
Yeah.
So, whatever happened to that precious UP3 you used to worry about all the time?
Yes. Well, I've made up my mind. I'll do whatever it takes to end this war. That's all.
There are things I can do that no one else can do. If there's a chance I can help... Cool, kid. Very cool.
Either way... we've interfered so much already, it's not going to make any difference, is it? And there's no guarantee we'll ever get off this planet.
Making a virtue of necessity, huh?
Is that wrong? I have to do something if I'm ever going to get out of here and find my dad.
You got the right idea, and I think you could use a little gung-ho, you know?
You think?
Well, that's the way I prefer to do things anyway. All right, let's go. She's waiting.
Took you long enough. What were you talking about?
Oh, nothing. I was just asking him if he's gonna miss Amina.
Silly question. Of course he will.
Lay off the teasing, all right? It's not like we're going out, jeez. Oh yeah, about the doctor? Thanks.
Don't thank me. I was just doing what I wanted to do.
But...
Actually, that doctor is one of my subordinates.
You mean like Tynave?
Well, they're not all doing the same thing, but they are all agents of Aquaria, and they help me out when I need it.
How nice.
Just the same. Please accept my gratitude.
I said don't worry about it.
What is it?
Can I really believe what you said back there?
About what?
That you'll do what you can. I take that to mean you'll cooperate with us?
Yes, I will.
Huh. Well, I welcome your change of heart. I'll have to thank Amina and her friend, but are you really sure about this?
I'm just going along with what he decides.
Right. I've made up my mind.
In that case, thanks in advance.
You're welcome. Now, let's get to Aquios.
Thank you. One.
City.
Yes. It's the pride of our kingdom. But there are people trying to take this city for themselves.
Aeroglyph, huh?
Yes.
Now, what happens next?
First, I'll introduce the two of you to our ruler.
You mean, the queen?
That's right.
So what's this queen like, anyway? I was kind of hoping she'd be hot, myself.
Look, Cliff. Whatever you do, please don't say something like that in front of Her Majesty.
Come on, you know I'm just teasing. It's a J-O-K-E.
Yeah, right.
No, really.
Shall we go then?
Let's. The castle is straight down this road.
Hey! Hey, wait up, you guys!
Spear of Might!
Spear of Might!
Ta! shockwave!
What goes around comes around.
Strike the first blow.
real fight!
Looks like a good fight.
Spear of Might! Hammer of Might! Spear of Might! Hammer of Might!
I'd have preferred a more worthy opponent.
Thank you. Lies ahead. The chapel is not open for worship at this time.
If you are here to worship, come back later. Otherwise, you best leave.
At ease.
Lady Nell!
So these guys... I mean, these gentlemen are...
That's right. We'll be going in now.
Yes, ma'am!
Yes, ma'am.
We're going to the audience chamber upstairs.
What's in there?
That's the chapel. Pilgrimages to Kadan, the holy land of Apris, involve such a long and treacherous journey that most people just do their worshiping here, in the castle chapel.
The chapel?
If you're interested, go take a look later.
I might just do that.
The audience chamber is this way. Follow me. I have returned, Your Majesty.
You have done well. Are these the ones?
Yes, Magistrate Lascelles.
Lift your faces. Her Majesty will speak now. Listen well to her words.
Welcome, engineers of Greeton, to the sacred kingdom of Aquaria. I am the queen of this country, Romeria Zin Emuril.
My name is Fate Lineguard.
My name is Cliff Fitter, Your Majesty. I am deeply honored and grateful for this audience with your royal person.
We have summoned you to this royal palace to request your assistance. As you may have heard, our country is at war with Eriglyph, and the war is not going well for Aquaria. The situation calls to mind Chapter 15 of Ikalos' Book of Prophecies, a book that contains the holy teachings of Apris.
Ikalos' Book of Prophecies?
Chaos in the Holy Land. The chaos shall spread catastrophe, and from that catastrophe shall be born a new maelstrom of war. It is our belief that this prophecy is about to come true. And we believe that you are the arrow of which the prophecy speaks. Our country is now embroiled in a war with Eriglyph. Unless something is done, our innocent citizens shall perish. We beg of you to lend us your strength.
Please, Your Majesty, I don't know what we'll be able to do, but we will do all we can. That is why we came here.
We are in your debt.
Guard? Show the travelers from Greeton to the guest quarters.
Yes, sir. These are your quarters. You may stroll around the castle as you wish. If you need something, ask the nearest soldier.
Thanks, pal. So what are you gonna do?
What do you mean, do?
They said you could walk around the castle if you want to. I think I'm gonna go check out the chapel.
The chapel?
Yeah, well, I'm an atheist myself, but I'm sorta interested in the art.
You? Interested in art?
Hey, don't laugh. I'm actually a bit of an artiste myself, although you wouldn't think it to look at me. Mirage said as much.
She did?
That's right. She said, you're the kind of guy who decides with his emotions before using his head. In other words, she thinks I'm an impressionist.
I don't think that's what she meant.
Yeah, she also said I'm always looking at pretty women, which I guess was her way of praising my keen sense of aesthetics, don't you think?
I wonder.
Well, anyway, there you have it. Be back in a bit. Oh, you're back. See anything interesting?
Not really. Cliff?
Hmm?
You told me I'd understand everything once I met Quark's leader, right?
I don't think I said everything, but yeah.
But you didn't expect things to turn out this way either, did you?
Not really.
So tell me, who's the leader? What will I understand? Why did the Vendini capture my dad? You know something, don't you?
I don't know everything, but what I do know wouldn't do you any good anyway.
But I may never find out.
Relax. You'll see your dad again. I'll make sure of it. Just be patient.
I'm coming in.
Morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Did you sleep well?
Yeah, thanks.
Today we're going to the Runological Weapon Research Facility.
Oh, that where they're making that weapon?
Yes. It's time. Time for you to lend us your knowledge.
Sure, but until we actually see it, we can't make any promises.
Of course. First, I want you to meet the person in charge. Her lab is on the west side of the castle. Shall we then? It's me. I brought the engineers.
Please come in.
That's Lady Elena, head of Aquaria's first Runological Weapon Development Division. Lady Elena, these are the two engineers for my report.
I'm Elena Fromm, leader of Runological Weapon Development.
Nice to meet you. I'm Fate Line God.
Howdy, Cliff Fitter.
A pleasure to meet you. I have to admit, they're much younger than I expected.
Yet they are knowledgeable.
I read the report. I do not doubt your information. It looks like we have no choice but to rely on that knowledge. We still haven't been able to analyze that metal fragment.
Did you call for me, Lady Elena?
Yes, Dion. Come in.
Pardon my interruption. Is this them?
Yes. The big one is Cliff, and the smaller one, Fate. This is my right-hand man, Dion Landers, Chief Researcher of Runological Weapon Development.
I'm Dion. Pleased to meet you. I hear you are men of learning. We're hoping you can impart some of your wisdom upon us.
I don't mean to rush you, but would you take a look at the runological weapon we're working on? A number of structural issues have been troubling us.
Sure, no problem.
Dion, can you show them the way, please? I can't leave my desk right now.
Absolutely. Please, this way. I must admit, I am surprised. I thought you would be a bit older.
I'm impressed that you're chief researcher at such a young age.
Well, I'm still an apprentice compared to Lady Elena.
Dion? Stop jabbering there. Hurry up and show them.
Yes, Lady Elena. Please forgive me. Oh, she's mad at me now. Let's go. This way, please.
This is the Runological Weapon Research Lab, where we do the basic design work for new weapons. The weapon we'd like you to take a look at is in the fabrication room. This is what I wanted you to take a look at.
What's the matter with this thing?
The device itself is basically complete, but it lacks the punch we need for it to work as a weapon. But if we increase the output, we run into durability problems.
I see.
Wait. Something's not right. Should a planet at this level of civilization even have a weapon like this? This technology is obviously too advanced for them to have.
What do you think? You see the problem? If you have any questions, I'll try to answer them.
No, I don't have any questions, but... I'm sorry. Can I take a look at it a little longer?
Sure. No problem at all. Take as long as you need.
Thank you. Should I really complete this thing? Even if I wasn't worried about the UP3... I get the feeling this is going a little too far.
Hey, come here.
What is it?
I'm no expert, but, doesn't this smell a little fishy to you?
Yeah, it's definitely too advanced. This sort of thing shouldn't even exist on a planet at their stage of development.
So, you gonna help them?
I'm not sure. What do you think?
Me? Well, if we finish it, lots of people are gonna die. Question is, are we okay with that? I mean, I don't like doing something that I can't take responsibility for myself. It'd be different if I were the one making the decision to fire, but the idea of some other guy who ain't me deciding what to do with a weapon I created, that kinda bugs me.
But this country, with its symbological technology, might be able to complete this weapon eventually, even if we don't help them. Maybe.
Yeah, maybe. Anyway, like I said before, you make the call.
What should I do? I'll do it. I'll help them.
What about your beloved UP3, huh?
I know this weapon might cause great suffering. But, on the other hand, think of the suffering it can prevent.
Okay, so what do you want me to do?
Huh? But I thought you didn't...
Who said I wouldn't help you? You've prepared yourself for the consequences, so as your bodyguard, I'd best do the same.
Thanks.
Well, I don't exactly want to die like a dog on this backwater planet either. So let's hurry up and finish this, make a communicator, and get out of here. We still gotta rescue your dad, too, so let's not waste any time.
Right. Mr. Landers?
Just call me Dion. What is it?
Dion, can I see the blueprint for this weapon?
Sure, no problem. Come on over to the lab. This is it?
Thank you. Can I also have some paper and something to write with, please?
Sure, use this.
Dion, what kind of wire are you using to conduct the runological power?
Iron wire, why?
Iron. Okay, that explains why the wire can't take the heat when you increase the output.
Yes, that's our biggest problem.
When you increase the power, it breaks. And when you decrease the power, you can't use it as a weapon, that it? Bummer.
Superconducting aluminum would easily solve this problem, but that's not an option here.
Superconducting aluminum?
Never mind. Just talking to myself. Dion, have you tried copper?
No. Well, I know that copper would probably solve the overheating issue, but...
Is there a problem?
We can't obtain enough copper to complete this device.
You don't have any mines?
No, there's a mine. It's just...
Wild dragons have taken up residence there.
Even one dragon would be a terrible enemy, so there's no way we could ever enter a whole nest of them, and mining is out of the question.
Dragons. Well, that explains it.
The mine in question is in Aeriglyph territory, and is under the jurisdiction of the Dragon Brigade.
The Dragon Brigade?
Even if we were successful in obtaining the copper, there's no guarantee that we'd be able to make it back here safely.
So you see the problem.
Your average guy doesn't stand a chance against wild dragons and the Dragon Brigade.
Huh. Copper's really our best bet. What should we do?
What are you talking about? All we have to do is go and get it.
Can we?
Of course we can. Do I look like an average guy to you? I got no problem with dragons. No problem at all.
I sure appreciate your groundless self-confidence in situations like this.
Groundless? You're pretty rude, you know that? Don't you think it's about time you admitted how tough I am?
It's not that I don't admit it. I just think you're a little overconfident, that's all.
Whatever.
You can't be seriously considering going. Just the two of you.
What are you talking about? It won't be just the two of them. I'm going too.
You too? It's still insane.
Don't worry. They may be engineers, but they really can fight. They've already proven themselves against the Black Brigade.
Maybe so, but still.
But we won't be able to carry all that copper by ourselves. We'll need to bring several people with us just to transport it. How much do we need?
Several dozen kilos, I'd say.
All right. No problem. My subordinates should be able to handle that much by themselves. We'll take Tynave and Farlene.
You insist on going, don't you? Well, all right, but don't take any unnecessary risks.
I know. I swear, you're just like Claire, always worried.
And Dion, take this.
What's this?
I glanced over your blueprint and jotted down a number of problem areas and possible solutions. You can deal with these while we're out getting the copper.
Of course. Yes, yes, I see. This should be a dramatic improvement.
Well, it's really nothing.
All right, get to work, Dion.
Yes, ma'am. And please, be careful.
I'll go gather my team. Let's meet up at the entrance to Aquios once you're ready.